So we'll start from one of the methods. It's called as dividend growth model. It's for finding out the KE. According to the model, the cost of equity is a function of the current market price and the future expected dividend of the company. So what does the equity investor want? He wants a dividend. So we based upon the dividend, we try to find out the KE. Okay, so D0 plus 1G, solve this and add the final G. You will get the answer. We'll work out these problems later. So we'll look at the theory here. The DVM model states, these are the assumptions. Okay, these are the assumptions. Future income stream is the dividends paid out by the company. So the income of the company is captured in the D0 or dividend. So that's a assumption. Dividends will be paid in perpetuity. That is, the company is always going to pay dividend. Dividend will be constant or growing at a fixed rate. So all these three assumptions should be applicable. Only if it is applicable for a company, you can use this method to value to find out the cost of capital. So what is the weakness of the model? First one, this model does not take risk itself into account. Two, capital gains is not all taken into account. Only the dividend part is taken into account. Three, taxation is also not taken into account. Four, there are different types of price. Okay, so the model works like this: D1 plus G divided by P. The price, the P refers to the equity share price. There are different prices for the same share in the market. For example, 52 week high, 52 week low, average price for the year. So which number we should take, that is a question mark. Dividends actually do not grow smoothly in reality. So the G that we take here, okay, the growth rate in dividend that we take here, is an assumption. The model does not produce meaningful result if no dividends is paid. So assume that D0 itself is zero, is just zero. So the answer is zero. Okay, so this model cannot be working in all the places. This model has several weaknesses, and this might be asked as a theory question, as a part of a 10 mark or a 20 mark question. So you should be able to know the weakness of this model exactly. The weakness of the model can be memorized in terms of these things. D is a drawback, okay. G is a kind of a drawback. The P is a kind of a drawback. There's no tax, there is no taxation, there's no capital gain, there's no risk. Then you have P is a problem, D is a problem, also G is a problem, okay. So you can easily crunch these weaknesses much more better. So in the dividend method, the first one is called as constant dividends, where this is a formula. KE refers to cost of equity, D divided by P0, where D refers to the constant dividend, and P0 refers to the price of the price today, or we called it as 0 year price. So that is about the formula here. So usually all these formulas are expressed in terms of percentages. So multiply 100 even if the formula doesn't have the number. Okay, so we'll start from this question. It says a company has paid a dividend of 30 cents for many years. The company expects to continue paying dividends at this level in the future. So in the past also they have paid 30 cents, in the future also they are going to pay 30 cents. So the dividend is going to be constant, so it's a constant dividend. The company's share price is 1.5, so they're asking you to calculate the KE. So as it is a constant dividends method, we can use this formula. So the formula is KE D divided by P0 into 100. So here the dividend refers to 30 cents. So if it's 30 cents, put it as 0.3 divided by the share price is 1.5 into 100. So the answer comes to 20%. So the KE is 20%. We'll move on to the next sum. Okay, so the next method is called as dividend method. Within that, assuming dividend growth at a fixed rate, so this is the formula: D0 into 1 plus G divided by P0, the whole of this plus G. Okay, so first solve all these within the bracket, then solve the G part. What does this refer to? See, D0 refers to the any zero number which is given refers to the starting year, okay, and any D1 refers to the next year, okay, the starting of the next year. So they say that D0, that is the dividend today, okay, into 1 plus G, that is the dividend is going to grow. The G here refers to the growth rate in dividend, the constant growth rate in dividends expressed as a decimal. So G refers to the growth of dividend. So if you are going to do this, you will be like getting D1. Okay, so this part of the equation is D1. The 0 plus the growth equals to the next year dividend. Okay, we can even put it like this. If there's D1 plus 1 plus G, then what you will get is you will get D2. Okay, you can keep on going like that. D2 plus 1 plus G will give you D3. Okay, but we are not like bothered about that. This is just for explanation. To do this sum, we just need to get the apply the numbers here. So we'll start. So we'll have KE. So KE equals to D0. What is D0 in this problem? We'll read. Pico has just paid a dividend of 10 cents. So it's 0.1. To 10 cents is 0.1. Shareholders expect dividends to grow at 7%. So 7% is 1 plus 7%. Pico's current share price is 2.05. So 2.05 is the P. The formula says D0 plus 1 D0 into 1 plus G divided by P0. So that's what we did. And finally, we have to add the G. So again, the G will be added as 7%. So we'll work it now. 0.1 into 1.07. So 7% has been added divided by 2.05. Plus the 7% can also be 0.07. So we'll solve the internal part of this. Internal part comes at 0.052. So we'll add the 0.07. It gives us 0.122. As we said, all these formulas should be expressed in percentage. So this can also be expressed as a percentage, like into 100 you put. So 12.2 is the cost of capital. Okay, so whatever answer you get, multiply it by 100, then only we will get the percentage. The company has recently paid a dividend of 0.23 per share. The current price is 3.45, and if dividends are expected to grow at an annual rate of 3%, what is the KE? So it's just as similar as the previous problem we did. So 0.23 is the dividend per share. The growth rate of dividend is 3% divided by 3.45, that's a share price. The whole of this is added with the 3%. So we have 0.23 into 1.03 divided by 3.45. All this has to be added with the 3%, so 3%. So we can solve now. Comes to 0.0686 plus we'll add the 0.03. So put together, the answer comes to 0.0986. So either it can be expressed like this, or you can multiply this with 100. Okay, you can multiply this with 100. The answer then comes to 9.86%. Okay, so the KE is 9.86. We'll move on to the next problem. So here we have a next concept. It's called as the X dividend share price. So it says the current share price is 140 cents, and a dividend of 8 cents is due to be paid shortly. Required, calculate the P0, the X dividend share price. So what is this X dividend share price? So in the formula, when we did it, for example, KE equals to D0 divided by P0, okay, or the other formula that we did, which is D0 1 plus G divided by P0 plus G, either this formula, the P0 here and here, okay, they refers to a price. What price? That is the X dividend share price, okay. So why should we take this X dividend share price? Because if you take a share price movement, What happens is, it might be trading at a price of 10 rupees for a long time, and suddenly the company might declare a dividend of 3 rupees. So once it has declared here, the share price will immediately fall to 7 rupees, and again it will trade. Now this part, okay, before this, it's called as come dividend price, and after the declaration of dividend, it's called as X dividend price. Okay, while computing the problem, should you take the come dividend price or the X dividend price? You should take the X dividend price. You have to find out the X dividend price and then use that as the P0 in the formula. So we'll work out this problem. So in this problem, he's asking you the X dividend price. So the X dividend price is, the formula works like this. Get the come dividend price minus the dividend. Minus the dividend. So the come dividend price is 140 cents. Dividend is 8 cents. So the X dividend price is 132 cents. Okay. So this is usually a part of a lengthier problem. So again, we have another problem here. The X dividend price. D is about to pay a dividend of 15 cents. Shareholders expect dividends to grow at 6% per annum. D Co's current share price is 1.25. Calculate the cost of equity, he is asking. Okay, so look at this problem here. He says D Co is about to pay a dividend of 15 cents. Okay, so the company is going to pay 15 cents. It means this price is the come price. Okay, so we have to find out the X price. First, we will find out the X dividend price. So X dividend price equals to the come price, which is 1.25, minus the 15 cents. So the answer would be 1.1. okay, so we'll now do the formula. So the KE formula, we'll do formula is D into 1 plus G divided by P0 the whole of this plus G. So the D0 is 15 cents plus 1 plus G. 1 plus G is 1 plus 6% divided by the P0. P0 is 1.1. So take this number plus again the G. So this comes to 0.144 plus 0.06. So the answer comes to 0.204, or if it's expressed in percentage, 0.204 into 100, which is 20.4%. So that's the answer. KE is 20.4. We'll move on to the next problem. So here he's saying, sometimes we have to find out the growth rate in dividend. So he will not give you the G in the equation. So there are two ways to find out the G. So one is called as a past dividend method. So in past dividend method, if the growth rate can be again found in two ways in the past dividend method. For example, if only like 2 years numbers are given, okay, two dividend numbers are given, for example, the current year dividend and the last year figure, then this is the formula. Current year number divided by the last year's number, okay, minus 1 into 100. Mostly they won't tell you to find out this method. Okay, what they will ask you is to find out through the second method, the compound annual growth rate method, or the CAGR method, where the formula works like this: nth root divided by current figure. Okay, so the current year number, what is the current dividend, and the oldest dividend, and the oldest dividend. Okay, once you get an answer for this, once the answer you get, you have to minus it by 1. That answer you have to multiply by 100. You will get the growth rate G. Okay, so that's how the formula works. Here The word yen refers to the number of years of the dividend. So we'll work out this problem. The company currently pays a dividend of 32 cents. 5 years ago, the dividend was 20 cents. Estimate the annual growth rate in dividend. So we'll start with the dividend growth rate. So the number that you'll get is a percentage number. So we'll start. Nth root. So number of years is 5. Okay, so we have to get the fifth root. The latest dividend is 32 cents. And the oldest dividend is 20 cents. This answer minus 1 and then multiply it by 100, you will get the percentage. So first we will solve this part of the equation. So we will start. 0.32 divided by 0.2 is 1.6. So we have to get the answer for 1.6. So 1.6 comes to, this answer comes to 1.098. So from this you have to deduct 1 and multiply 100. We'll do it here. Deduct 1, the answer comes to 0.098. Then we have to multiply it by 100. We'll get 9.8%. So the growth rate in dividend is 9.8%. So how do you take this fifth root? See, you can't do this in a normal calculator. You can't do this in a normal calculator. You need a scientific calculator. You need this. So what is the step? So this is the step. First, press the number 5 in your scientific calculator. The second is press shift. Okay. The third is to press. There's a symbol like this. Okay. Press this symbol so that you will get this. This would equal you to this number. If you see your calculator, you will have this symbol. Okay. But when you press shift and you press power button, you will get the xth root. So you have already pressed the fifth, 5, and now it will give you the fifth root. So after this, your fourth work is to press the 1.6 and finally press the equal. You will get the answer in your scientific calculator. Okay. So these are the steps. Look for this symbol. Okay. That's like very important. And above this symbol, you have this also printed in your calculator. Okay. So these are steps to find out the nth root. So without scientific calculator, you can't work out this sum. So even in exam, you have to take the scientific calculator with you. So now we'll move on to the another problem. So it is the same as the earlier problem. The company has paid the following dividend over a period of 5 years. Okay. So how the again this works? So our job is we have to find out the growth rate in dividend. Our formula is N. So latest divided by oldest minus 1 and into 100. That is our job. So now the crucial part is N. In the question, if they are going to give you just years, then you can take 5 years. But if they are going to give you the first year, year number 2000, and the last year's and the latest year's year number as 2004, then in that terms, you can't take just like what he has given, like 5 years. You have to count it. So how many years are here? It's not like 5 years, because in cumulatively, if you take 2000 to 2001 is the first year. 1 to 2 is a second year, 2 to 3 is a third year, 3 to 4 is a fourth year. So there is actually not 5 years, there are only 4 years. Okay. So if he mentions you the year number, then you have to work out like this only. That is the only difference. Apart from that difference, the formula is same. The latest dividend is 14.5. The oldest dividend is 10 minus 1 into 100. So we will work out the problem. So we have to get the fourth root of 1.45, 1.077. So again minus 1 into 100. So that comes to 0.077 into 100. So that comes to 7.7%. So that is the growth rate in dividend. So we'll move on to the next problem. So there is a second model in which we have to find out the growth rate in dividend. So that is called as the earnings retention model or Gordon's growth model. The formula is like very simple. The growth rate in dividend is B into R. So what is R? R refers to the rate of return on investment or ARR. So you have to take the ROI or ARR. And B refers to the earnings retention rate. So what is retention rate? Retention rate is, if a company earns profit, it can do two things with that. One, it can declare it as dividend or have it as reserve. Okay, it can do two things with its profit. So retention rate is how much of profit is retained. So we can put it like this. So it can we can refer the B like this. B equals to earnings minus dividend divided by earnings. So earnings minus dividend is what is being like retained. Okay, so this is the reserve part. So into 100. So if you do this, you will get the B. So we'll try to do it. A company has a profit after tax of 1 lakh and declares a dividend of 40,000 every year. It has an average ROI of 25%. What is the dividend growth rate? So we'll start from the B, okay, earnings retention ratio. See, the earnings is 1 lakh. The company has made a profit of 1 lakh. 40,000 has been declared as dividend. That means 60,000 is retained by the company. So 60,000 has been retained by the company. It means that they are retaining 60%. So their B is 60%. So we will solve it again. We will try to get the G dividend growth rate in dividend. So the formula is B into R. B, just now we found out it is 60% into what is R. R is directly given as 25%. So we will try to find out this number, 0.15. So as this has to be in a percentage, we will multiply it by 100. So we will get an answer of 15%. So the growth rate in dividend is 15%. Okay, so again, this is a 2-mark problem, or this might come as a part of a 10-mark problem.
You can reach me at my website wowacademics.com, or you can also see my Quora answers. I am active in LinkedIn and in Facebook page, so you can visit at these places. If you just type Shyam Prasad and Wow Academics, you will get all these links in Google search itself. And if you like this video, give a like, share to your friends, and if you feel that any points we have missed in this video, you can post it. We will try to give an answer to you in the comment section itself, or we'll also create another video for you. So thank you for watching our video.